U.S. researchers might have discovered a successful vaccine to fight malaria, one of the world's deadliest diseases. Malaria killed more than 500,000 people in 2010, and 3.3 billion live in areas at risk. The disease causes fever and can block the flow of oxygen to the brain, and is usually transmitted when mosquitoes bite. But the new vaccine, made from a weakened version of the disease, had promising results in its first round of clinical testing, like 100% effective promising. It's the first time a malaria vaccine trial has been so successful, but the head of preventative medicine at Vanderbilt University's medical school says more research needs to be done. From the point of view of science, dealing with one of the big three infectious causes of death around the world, it's a notable advance, and everybody will be holding their breath, watching to see whether this next trial works and how well it works. In addition to more testing, Nature reports another challenge this new vaccine needs to overcome is how difficult it is to make. Lead researcher Stephen Hoffman raised mosquitoes in sterile conditions, fed them malaria-infected blood, and irradiated them to weaken the parasite. Billions of parasites were then harvested from the mosquito's salivary glands, purified and cryopreserved. NBC reports the director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases brought up another important question. The vaccine may be 100% effective, but for how long? A mere 3 weeks after receiving the last dose of the vaccine, the volunteers were exposed to the malaria infection again, and a few tested positive that time. But any research with such a hopeful start is enough to get global health workers excited. According to the World Health Organization, funding in the fight against malaria plateaued in 2012, with nowhere near the amount needed to eradicate the disease. Hoffman hopes to have a vaccine license within the next 4 years. The findings were published in the journal Science. For Newsy, I'm Candace Aviles.